next will be your GIS data types, where we are going to discuss about the topology and all. Learning objective: explain the basic concept of raster and vector data, describe the overview of team, triangulated irregular network, illustrate about the topological relationship, as I have already mentioned in the previous section. Now get an idea of the raster and vector data format. Now, raster data. Raster data, as we all know, any digital picture is a raster data. That means it's a pixelated data. So all the pixels, it contains a digital information, a number. Okay, 8-bit image, 60, all this, right? And a particular number which actually contains that information. That means if you zoom a particular picture, then you'll be able to identify these pixels, like square pixel cells. Raster data represents any element on the real world into an array of rectangular cells. This array of these rectangular cells are known as a pixels. This particular data is very useful because it's a simple data structure, easy and efficient overlaying. You can overlay different, you know, raster files one over another in GIS environment. Okay, and it's a high spatial variability is efficiently represented. Suppose you have a picture of, this is also we do in our real life, suppose the picture of Guwahati in 1901, if someone has taken, okay, or suppose the picture of Guwahati in 1947, 15 August 1947, a picture of Guwahati Panbazar today, you can compare, right, the spatial variability. So it is very efficient way. Visually we can understand, okay, there is a difference, some development has occurred, okay. So this is very easy, it enables the raster data set. Now next one is a vector data. Now this vector data is consists of discrete geometric locations. Okay, discrete geometric locations. Now these vectors are the graphical objects that have, you know, geometric primitives such as point lines and polygons will be our vector data. Okay, as because this vector data consists of the discrete geometric locations, so these are going to have a well-defined geometry, which doesn't exist in case of your raster data set because it is an array of picture cells. Okay, now this vector data is very useful. Why? Because they have a small file size, individual identity, like points will be kept as a point vector data, lines will be kept as a line vector data, okay, area will be kept as a area vector data. Okay, so this vector data are the feature class. Okay, as we have already discussed, feature class under a geodatabase. Okay, or there are different formats of this vector data which I am going to discuss. Now, this here you can make the distinction between the raster data and vector data. Now, same points here are represented as picture cells. Okay, lines in vector data, picture cells. Now, this is a comparison between the raster data and the vector data. Okay, so structure, grid in case of raster data, vector data, points, line and polygons, specific geometry. Okay, representation, each cell stores a single value or attribute, number. Okay, and geometric shapes with associated attributes, geometric shapes with associated attributes. Then your topology encodes spatial relationship. I'm going to, you know, discuss it in detail. Analysis, raster data suited for the continuous analysis, vector data suitable for the discrete analysis. And there are, like, for our satellite images, any satellite images, Google Earth, this is a raster data, okay? Or the GIS environment, the data we are going to create, the geometric roads, lines, points, areas will be your vector data set. Now there is another difference between vector and raster. Okay, we'll continue. Later we'll deal with it. This is a triangulated irregular network. This is also belong to a category of vector data. Basically, this thin data represents the elevation. Okay, and it enables us to visualize the elevation. So can you see? We can visualize the elevation here. Okay, so this thin is a three-dimensional data representation model in the GIS environment. It's a three-dimensional data where we'll have X, Y, and Z information. Okay, So each node in the team data, each node in the team data will have the altitudinal information. Okay, and if we visualize this thin surface in GIS environment, the particular points, the nodes will be elevated with respect to its elevation. Okay, elevation information, it will be elevated. Then you will be able to get the 3D feel in the GIS environment. So team data actually enables us to do the three-dimensional analysis, triangulated irregular network. Okay, now here comes the topographical relationship, the spatial relationship. Now this topology in GIS refers to the spatial relationship, connectivity, contiguity, proximity and all. So to understand the topology, basically it focuses on understanding and representing how different spatial elements are related to each other in terms of its adjacency, connectivity, containment or other geometric relationship. For instance, if we are drawing a line connecting two points, okay, so your topology will be that this particular line has to touch the point A and B. So this is a relationship, because this particular line, we know that indicates the distance between point A and B. You must have to join these two points to get the distance. Or for instance, suppose you are creating a polygon data set for the districts of Assam. Now in the polygon data set for the districts of Assam, each of these adjacent polygons, they must, you know, overlay with each other. There cannot be any empty spaces, right? Two polygons suppose you have drawn, okay? So if this, there is any gap between the two polygons, then it will create a third polygon. Suppose the two districts, suppose Nogaon and Morigaon districts, the boundaries are, you know, has to be common of these two polygons, okay? The boundary shared by between Nogaon and Morigaon or Nogaon and Gulaghat. Now suppose while creating the polygon, if you have, you could not achieve the boundary overlay between Nogaon and Gulaghat district, then there will be gaps. Now these gaps in a polygon environment will be treated as another polygon. Now what about it? It is going to be a new entity which doesn't exist in the real world. Okay, so here you can define the relationship that there cannot be any gap in between two adjacent polygons. So this is the topological relationship. Okay, or suppose you know that two parallel roads you are drawing. Okay, now these two parallel roads you can define, because you know that in real world they do not overlap. Okay, so in the GIS environment you can define the topology prior to creation of these two polylines. You can define that they must not overlap. Okay, then whenever you try to overlap these two, you know, lines, then the error will be shown, error will be indicated. Okay, so or suppose you are drawing some ISO lines. If you are aware of the ISO lines, ISO lines connected the points with the equal information, equal data. Suppose for instance, suppose contours are the ISO lines connecting points with same elevation. Now we know the ISO lines cannot intersect each other. So this is a topological relationship. In GIS environment, we can define this topological relationship while creating the different features. Okay, so this is the, you know, very powerful actually relationship tool which is present in the GIS environment. Now topological relationships, there are mainly three types of topological relationship: connectivity, area definition and contiguity. Okay, now I'm going to deal them one by one, like topological rules in case of polygon. Can you see I have just listed few of these topological rules, like polygon must not overlap, okay, must not have any gaps. Can you see, as I have already cited this example. Okay, for line must not overlap, I have already cited one example. Okay, must not intersect for ISO lines, I have already cited that example. So these are the topological relationship you can define while creating the feature data set, feature classes. Okay, point must be covered by boundary of, suppose Guwahati must be within the boundary of Kamrup metro district. Okay, if it is falls outside, then it will, the error will be shown. So these are the topological relationship, the connectivity, contiguity, proximity, Okay, these relations can be defined using the topology in GIS environment. Okay, now these are the common raster and vector data formats. For raster data, like JPG, okay, widely known raster data format. In our mobile phones or cameras, we are capturing the images in JPEG format. PNG, okay, point network graphics or graphic interchange format, tag image file format, or IMG format in case of your satellite images, IMG format, okay. Vector data, SHP, commonly used in the ArcGIS platform, okay, for shape files. KML, keyhole markup language, particularly it is used in a Google Earth analysis and all. GPX, particularly used for capturing the GPS data, GNSS data, okay, GPX, okay, Tiger or GeoJSON. These are the popular vector data format, okay, which we are going to use. So these shape files in a within a geo database is a feature class. Okay, this shape file within a geo database is a feature class, and combination of feature class will be your feature data set. Now here I would like to show you a basic difference between the raster data and the vector data. That origin is different actually in case of your raster and vector data. You see, as we have already defined the vector raster data, what it is? Array, right? So in case of your array of pixels, if I have to refer to this particular pixel, okay, then suppose it is A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, this particular pixel will be referred as A1. Okay, and the subsequent pixels will be identified. So here, the origin is actually left top. See, for raster data. For vector data, XY coordinate. Suppose this is a point. We know the line will be the combination of three points. Three. Suppose this is a line feature. So line feature, point feature. XY coordinate. Okay, now here the origin will be left bottom. See, basic difference. So suppose this particular point will be given as x1 y1. Okay, this will be given as x2 y2. So here we are going to start at the bottom left, top right. Basic difference between the raster data and the vector data.